Discuss the phenomenon called action of points. It is also called corona discharge. On the screen you see two metal spheres, both of them are positively charged. You can also see that the positive charges all reside on the outer surface of the sphere. It's a metal sphere, and the charges, even if they are given to the inner side of the metal sphere, they all go to the outer side and then reside over there. And they are placed over insulating stands. The red color object here is the insulating stand. And because it is insulating in nature, the charges on the metal spheres cannot conduct themselves to the ground or the surface. Okay. Now, scientists who did the experiments with these kinds of objects, they found out that the charges that are present on the spheres could stay there for a very long time. That means they got retained in the metal spheres for a very long time. But then, when sharp-edged objects or sharp-edged conductors were attached to the spheres, like I have drawn in the second one, what they found was the charges that were present on the metal spheres, they all were very quickly leaking away. So it left with this kind of an object. That is, all the charges are leaking away. So this was the observation. And they also found out that the charges were like leaking through these sharp pointed, say, metal structures or pointed, say, conductors. This phenomenon therefore is called action of points. So here the word point refers to the point edged or pointed conductors. So we can define the action of points like this. The action of points is thus defined as the leakage of charges through the sharp edges or points of a charged conductor. Okay, so what is the reason? What could be the reason why this is happening? Okay, so we can just once again draw the sharp conductors there. Let us say this is the sharp conductor which is attached to it. There could be more than one also. Now, according to the theory called distribution of charges on metal conductors or metals, there is a theory which states that the surface charge density of charges on metals is inversely proportional to the radius of curvature of the conductor, which means the greater the radius of curvature, the smaller the charge density. And the smaller the radius of curvature, the greater will be the charge density. And as you can see here, in all these places, everywhere, the radius of the metal is the same. On the other hand, over here, where the sharp edge is present, the radius is almost zero. What is the radius of a dot? You must understand that a full stop or a dot is a circle with zero radius. So likewise, the sharp edge has very little radius, and hence, according to the theory, the surface charge density sigma is the greatest at that point. And since the sharp edge is also connected to the metal sphere as well, all the charges that are present on the metal sphere, most of them, now they go and then occupy the small space at the sharp edge. So we can just mark it like this. So most of these charges, charges that are present over here, they all get diverted and most of them go to the sharp edge. But of course some of the charges will also be there, but it will be very very sparse and scattered. So most of the charges are all over here. This leads to a situation that the immediate neighborhood, that is this region, the immediate neighborhood of the sharp edge is experiencing very large electric field, or enormous electric field is present in the immediate vicinity or neighborhood of the sharp edge. So this huge electric field in this region, in the region over here, okay, creates ions in the air molecules. So what is surrounding the say sharp edge? It's only the atmosphere or air. So what is in the air? Air molecules. So the air molecules are usually neutral, but then because of this large electric field in this region or in the neighborhood of the sharp edge, the air molecules are ionized. Ionized means removal of electrons. So from the air molecule, say for instance oxygen, electrons are removed, and hence, since the electrons, you must know, are negatively charged, they are released out of the oxygen molecule, and the oxygen molecule itself becomes positive in nature. So you have a pair of positive and negative charges created because of the large amount of electric field, positive as well as negative charge. Negative is due to the electrons and positive is basically the ion. So this kind of positive and negative charges in pairs, large number of them are created in the neighborhood. So we will mark a few of them here and there. So these are the ions created in the neighborhood of the sharp edge, and this is due to the huge electric field, and the electric field is created due to the surface charge density being very large in the area. Now what happens? The negative charges are attracted by the presence of the positive charges at the sharp edge, and the positive charges are repelled. So the positive charges move away, they all move away from this corner, whereas the negative charges, they are all attracted towards the sharp edge. So this is what they call an electric wind. Since the positive charges are basically the ions of the air molecule, they are heavy and they move, as they move away from the sharp edge, they create a kind of an electric wind. So this was captured in this particular figure you can see here. So the metal spheres there are shown in the image here, they are positively charged, and as you can see, the candle by the side of it is fluttering, and then it is sideways, it is glowing sideways. Usually the candle flame is upright, vertically upright, but here it is horizontal because of the presence of the electric wind. So the electric wind is the positive charge moving away. Okay, this is the experimental proof for the presence of the electric wind. Now what will the electric wind further do? Since the negative charges are all coming to the sharp edge, attracted by the positive charges present there, the positive charges that are present there are neutralized by the negative charges that are now coming and settling on them. So soon you will find out that the positive charges present over here, they are all completely vanishing. So this is what they say, leaking of charges. Actually there is no leaking of charges, but in fact neutralization of the charges by the presence of the negative charges around it. So soon you will find out that even these charges that are present, they all see the same fate. They all get leaked away from the sharp edges, and hence the word leakage of charges through the sharp edges of a charge conductor. So this phenomenon is called action of points.